Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 26 in the Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to discuss on the flow with oblique shocks. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the flow with normal shock and we solved the problem with the normal shock. In this lecture, we will be discussing flow with the oblique shock and we will differentiate between normal and the oblique shock. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define oblique shock and differentiate between normal and the oblique shock. So, the shock wave, normally it occurs in the flow transition from supersonic flow to subsonic flow, particularly in the diffuser or divergent part of the nozzle. So, mainly the shock wave occurs in the diffuser, because in the diffuser, supersonic diffuser, particularly in the aircraft engines, the air enters the jet engine with a supersonic speed. At the entrance of the jet engine, we have a diffuser where the oblique shock will be standing at the entrance, which converts the velocity into pressure. And we studied in the normal shock wave that the across the shock wave, after the shock wave or the downstream of the shock wave, there is drastic increase in the pressure. So, the main objective of the shock wave is to convert velocity into pressure to create more pressure on the downstream side of the shock wave. And in the normal shock wave, we said the normal shock wave always perpendicular to the flow direction, always it is standing perpendicular to the flow direction. When the shock wave is inclined to the flow direction, then it is called as oblique shock wave. So, look at here, this is the direction, there is a change in the direction of the fluid. So, when there is change in the direction of the fluid and the shock wave is referred as oblique shock wave. So, this is the upstream side of the flow and this is the direction change for the flow in the downstream side, and this is the angle by which the flow is deflected, and this shock wave which is standing is known as oblique shock wave. The compression wave inclined at an angle to the flow direction is called as oblique shock wave. So, it is always compression shock wave, because the fluid is compressed across the shock wave. The angle by which the shock wave is inclined to the flow direction is known as wave angle sigma. So, the angle of the shock wave is called as wave angle, which is sigma. And this is the example for the oblique shock wave in a wedge. When the air is flowing in a wedge or a blended rectangular pipeline, so you may find the shock wave is forming with an angle that is on the upstream side the Mach number is greater than 1 supersonic flow, and the downstream side the Mach number will be less than 1. And this is a practical image of formation of oblique shock wave when a jet engine is flying in the air. So, the inclined wave, inclined lines, they are the oblique shock waves. And this is the shock wave, oblique shock wave formed in the turbo machine. So, the flow passage between the blade. So, this is one aerofoil blade, this is another aerofoil blade. Between the flow passage, when there is change in the flow Mach number, so from supersonic condition to the suddenly subsonic condition, there will be a shock wave formed. But this is undesirable phenomena in the case of turbo machine. And this is an oblique shock wave which is formed in the atmosphere because of the air jet. And this is the explosion of bomb. Here again we may find the shock wave. Because of the explosion, there is a drastic pressure rise which causes the drastic pressure rise and temperature rise after the wave. The shock wave with a very small wave angle are called as Mach waves or the weak shock waves. So all the shock waves are not compression waves. Some waves they are called as weak shock waves or the Mach waves, where the wave angle is very, very small. The difference between normal and the oblique shock. The oblique shock waves are inclined with respect to the incidental flow direction, while the normal shock wave are always normal to the flow direction. So, oblique shock wave, they are inclined to the flow direction. The normal shock wave, the upstream and the downstream flow directions are unchanged across the shock. Whereas, across the oblique shock, the flow gets turned and the flow direction downstream is different from the upstream flow direction. So there is a change in the direction for the fluid flow from the upstream to the downstream side across the oblique shock wave. So the analysis of the oblique shock wave. So we assume this is the oblique shock wave standing, so with an angle delta. So delta is, so this is the surface through which the fluid is getting deflected, and the deflection angle delta equal to theta 2 minus theta 1. So refer to the diagram, theta 1 is the angle here, velocity absolute angle of the absolute velocity at the upstream side, theta 2 is the angle of upstream angle of the absolute velocity on the downstream side. Theta 2 minus theta 1 is the deflection angle. So delta is the deflection angle, and sigma is the wave angle. So this is the angle, wave angle is sigma. So the assumptions for the analysis of oblique shock wave, the flow is frictionless and adiabatic, no external work or heat transfer involved, the effect of body force are negligible, the fluid behaves as a perfect gas and the properties are constant, and the flow is streamlined flow. So the it is a laminar flow. So streamlined flow means laminar. These are all the assumptions. But how we are going to do the analysis using the only the converting the angle using the angle of the deflection and the make a wave angle, we convert the problem into normal shock wave and we solve the problem. So solving problem with oblique shock waves. So knowing the value of M1. So Mach number on the upstream side and the sigma, the wave angle, calculate Mx. So Mx equal to M1 into sin sigma. So we convert the oblique shock into a normal shock by considering the Mach number and the wave angle. Take the properties ratio using the normal shock table. So Mx and gamma. So gamma is the gas constant specific heat ratio. The Mx is the Mach number, corresponding Mach number for the normal flow conditions. Calculate the properties on the downstream of the shock wave. So M2 equal to My divided by sine of sigma minus delta, P2 by P1 equal to POI by PX, T2 by T1 equal to TOI by TX, PO2 by PO1 equal to POI by POX, and PO2 by P1 equal to PO2 by PO, PO2 by P1 equal to POI by PX. So we convert the problem with the oblique shock into the normal shock type of problem, and we refer to the normal shock table and calculate the properties on the downstream side of the oblique shock wave. So this is the gas table. So here the gas table, we refer to the table number 5.1 and 5.2 for calculating the deflection angle or the Mach angle for the given wave angle for the given Mach number, and we refer the table number 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3 normal shock table, the property variation for normal normal shock wave for solving the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You refer to the subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. In the next lecture, we will be solving problems with the oblique shock. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So in the next lecture, we will solve problem from the anionic question paper in the oblique shock.